Good morning. Welcome back to Auto Technic. Today, got another little tech tip for you. Working on the exhaust tips for this 79 Centurion jet boat that we're restoring. And we have some seized and broken studs that I'm going to show you how to go ahead and get out. Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about what we're dealing with here. Now, as you can imagine, we have an aluminum exhaust tip with standard mild steel bolts, and obviously they're in a very wet environment hanging off the back of the boat. They've been on there for 43 years, so essentially these are seized into the housing. Luckily, when I removed it on these two studs, you can see that I was able to pull the bolts out and got the housing out. On this third stud here, it backed the stud out of the housing, so we were good to go there. On this other tip, which I've already addressed, it was more or less the same. I had one stud stuck in, one came out, and one actually broke in half and was seized into the housing. So I've already went ahead and removed these, and I have not done this one yet. So what I'm gonna do is show you the different ways that you can get these out. I'm sure we all know when removing studs that we can go ahead and double nut it and stack two nuts and twist the stud out. And I have already tried that on both of these and they didn't want to move. And I was worried about breaking the stud shorter and making this harder on myself to get out. The last thing I want to do is break the stud off down low to where it's close to flush with the aluminum, because it's going to be very difficult to get out. And really your only option at that point is to drill and tap it, and you have a harder steel stud, aluminum. It's very hard to get that right. Your drill bit's going to wander and your hole is going to be offset. It just turns into a big mess. So I do have stud removers here, but as you can see with these, a couple problems. I don't have enough space to get onto the housing, and also they don't grip very high up on the stud. So I again come back to the problem where I risk breaking the stud down at the bottom. So for these, I'm not going to be reusing these. If I was, I would double nut them, but I'm going to take these out and replace them with stainless steel studs. So I don't really need to worry about them. I just need to go ahead and use some vice grips and get them out. Now I have gone ahead and put the vice grips on and tried just to twist them out. And again, they're still in there and they're not going to come out that easily. So I let these sit on the bench and I hit them with some PB blaster, and I periodically would come back every couple of weeks and just spray them, because, well, I'm a long ways away from needing these exhaust tips right now. So as letting time help me out. So now that they've soaked up with PB blaster, is what I'm gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and heat it with that MAP gas torch, a little bit more blaster, some vice grips, and they should spin right out. After letting everything soak in PB blaster for a while, it was time to get the torch out and heat it up. Now notice that I'm focusing all of the heat on the torch on the aluminum housing, and I'm doing so because of the expansion rate of aluminum versus steel. The aluminum is gonna expand quite a bit more, and I wanna keep the heat off the stud. And my goal is to get the aluminum housing to expand, the stud to not expand, to give me enough clearance to get it out. You'll also notice that I sprayed more PB blaster on it to help kind of lubricate it on the way out and also still work as a penetrating oil. And also, as I work it out, I am going back and forth on it, not just twisting it in the counterclockwise direction, kind of like you would a thread tap, to help clear the threads and get it out without any galling. I'm essentially fighting galvanic corrosion on this exhaust tip, to where the two dissimilar metals between the aluminum housing and the steel bolt have essentially fused together over time because of the high moisture environment and just electrolysis. So there's really no thread damage into the housing, but I need to be cautious and careful on how I get that stud out so that way I don't induce any thread damage. And there you have it. Got them out without breaking them. Pretty easy. Once you have the bolts out, you're definitely gonna wanna go ahead and get these threads cleaned up in these tips. Now, most of us will just have a tap and die set and go ahead and run a tap in. But if you look, this tap is not a bottoming tap, and it will only probably get the very, maybe top three threads of that bolt hole before it bottoms out in there, because these holes are blind holes and so shallow. And also, taps are meant for tapping new holes where it will tend to basically make a sharper, rougher edge in that aluminum, and you're really running the risk of galling up your new fasteners, especially running stainless fasteners in there. So you're better off using a thread chaser kit, and these are meant to not remove material and cut threads, but only to clean them up. And also, if you notice how this is much flatter at the bottom, so it's going to go deeper into the hole. It's going to clean the threads up further down, not remove material, and it's better off in the long run. All right, guys, that's all I had for that tip. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to stop by the channel. Thanks for watching the video. If you haven't already, please subscribe, hit the like button, give me some comments below. We'll see you on the next video, guys.